If you're picking up SmartSuite for the first time, or if you've been using it for a while, but you know that there's just so many moving parts and you need a refresher on how it works, then this is going to be the perfect video for you. In this video, I am breaking down all the key components of SmartSuite so that you can start using it to its fullest and get the maximum efficiency out of this amazing tool. So if learning how to get started inside of SmartSuite is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get full potential out of the amazing no-code tools available to you. And SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down all the core components, as I mentioned, so that you can really unlock its full potential. But before we get into that, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you're new to no-code, the place where it's really going to benefit your life is in automation. Building automated processes in the back end so that you don't have to do them manually. If learning the foundation of no-code automation is of interest to you, you should grab my free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. There you can sign up and get immediate access to that training. It is tool agnostic, so regardless of where you're building your automation, you're going to get massive value from that training. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. I want to start talking about SmartSuite, this incredible software, and I encourage you to follow along with me in your own SmartSuite account. Go ahead and open it up. If you don't already have one, please consider signing up using our affiliate link that I will share here, and it's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. We greatly appreciate it. Let's go ahead and hop on in and get started. So the first piece here is just going to be understanding what I see when I first sign in. This is my SmartSuite dashboard, and I see the company, the workspace that I'm assigned to right here. And for me, that's going to be Gap Consulting, and because I'm signed in as me, it's greeting me. So this is my photo, my profile photo, it's saying hi to me. Fantastic. I know that I'm logged in as me. I feel secure that I'm in the right workspace. Now, the next part is going to be understanding what these icons are. Each one of these things is a solution. It's basically a database that has been built and shared with us inside of this SmartSuite workspace. So depending on our level of permissions, we are going to see more or less when we log in. So I am accessing this as a creator, somebody who has full access, full permissions. If your organization uses SmartSuite and you have a different level of permissions, you might not be able to do all of the same things I'm sharing here. In some cases, your permissions might be locked down so that you don't break things, you don't accidentally override a formula, those kinds of things. But for our purposes here today, I'm going to assume that you have that high level permission and that you can do all the things that I can do. So, inside of a solution, we can click any of these and it will open up this particular thing. Now, this is sales example. And the first thing I want to draw your attention to is that up at the top, we have three different tables here or tabs. Each one of these things is its own data set inside of this overall solution. So the overall solution is here, sales example. But inside of it, we have these tables, and each table represents a set of data. So here are accounts. We have, in this example, 12 different accounts. Over here in contacts, we have a number of different contacts. Oh gosh, it goes all the way down to 50 contacts that are linked to these different accounts. And so we have this way of connecting information across the different tables. I don't have to come in and reimagine Emma's Emporium every time. We see that there are a number of different times that we have contacts that are connected with that particular account. Now, lastly, we can go over to our pipeline. And in our pipeline, we can track and we have a linked relationship of a deal that we're working on that goes back to a contact. So here we have this pipeline deal with Amelia Johnson. We received the date or received the lead on a certain date. We can see the proposal date submitted. We can see when we won it. We have the value. And so we can track all of this information. Now, what we're looking at here is called a grid view. It looks kind of familiar, maybe like a spreadsheet. It's rows and columns. But in fact, SmartSuite is a lot more than that. So the next thing we need to understand is how data is stored. Each new record that we add to SmartSuite in a grid view shows up as a row. So it's just the next thing in that set of data. So let's go back to contacts. This might make more sense from a people perspective. So I've got these 50 different contacts in my database, and I can easily add a new one. I can just come down here, click, and add new contact, give them a name, etc. So over here, I'll write the name as new contact. And I can select done. I can bring in their email address, etc. This new thing that I've just added here, this is a record. And every piece of information that we store on behalf of that new contact, well, those different columns are called fields. What is the purpose of a field? Well, it stores a specific type of data for a specific purpose. So this field here is called email. We are using an email field type. So when you build a new field, you can select the type of data that's going to be stored in that field. Now, a key takeaway when building a database like this is that when you're adding new fields, you want to do it to the source. So for example, you might think about adding emails to your database as we have here. Where does it belong? Is email something that belongs at the contact level, at the deal level pipeline, or at the account level? Right? So make sure that you're adding it at the right level. In this case, email belongs to a person, and so we bring it into the contacts table. But maybe when we're looking at accounts, we need to know all the different email addresses associated with this account. That is possible. And we can bring that information in because we know the contacts that are associated with the different accounts, and we know the email addresses for the different contacts, so we can bring them here. So if for some reason we need to look that information up, well, I just gave it away. There's a special field type called a lookup. And this is how we add a new field to bring in information from a different set of data. So I can link to my contacts as I've done. I'm looking at that link and I want to bring in information assigned to those contacts. And here is access to those emails, and I can add this field. And by doing this, if we expand this column, we're going to see all the email addresses associated with all the different contacts. So this is the way that we can pass information through the different tables. Linking these different tables together is a big key concept to wrap your head around. When you first start working in a database, if this is your first time branching out from spreadsheets, this might feel a little bit unnatural, but you will get the hang of it very quickly. Now, the next thing to bring up, I mentioned it already, is views. This is a grid view. We're just looking at this information in rows and columns, but there's so much more we can do. Let's actually go back to our contacts here. Again, it's easy for us to think of these people, and we could imagine that we have a different field type as well of pictures, right? So we can actually bring in a files and images type here, and I can rename this to be profile pic, and let's add this field. So over here, I could, if Amelia Johnson, if I wanted to know what she looked like, I could find her image from online, drop it in here, and be good to go. Now, for our example, I'm going to bring in a picture that I have from my website. I'm just going to drag it in and drop it over here, and I'm going to upload it here to the system. So as that gets loaded, we're going to see that there's now a profile picture, and apparently that's what Amelia looks like. The reason I'm doing this is to share with you that depending on the type of data that you store, in this case, a JPEG, well, I can actually view the data in new and interesting ways. Rows and columns? That's old news. Let's talk about other types of views. We can create new views, and we can present our data in a number of different ways. I can look at my information on a calendar. I can do a Kanban view if I have a status where I'm moving something through a pipeline. I can look at card views, which we're going to do here. I also have Gantts, maps, charts, all kinds of different ways that I can still see the same data, but it's just going to be displayed to me in different unique ways. Here I'm going to bring in the card view. Let's create this new view. And the reason I'm doing this is because I can actually set up my cards to show that profile. So let's go to fields to display. And I just added that profile pic. And just like that, we can now see, here's Amelia. Let's click on this. We can see what Amelia looks like in this example. So In this way, we are able to absolutely change the way that our data shows up for us. We can, from the toolbar of any view, come and rearrange the information in a way that makes sense for what we're trying to accomplish. So if I were in a particular process where I only wanted to see people from a certain account, I can filter this. I can come in and say, well, I only want to see those people who are linked to accounts for about and forever. And just like that, I've reduced the amount of information here to where I'm only seeing these contacts. I can have any number of views, and I can create different folders for these views and store the views in different folders, share those views with different people on my team so that they can see just what they need to see in order to complete their job. Now, I've talked a lot about how to store data and connect data and view data, but the next part is perhaps the most powerful part of SmartSuite altogether, and that comes down to automation. Now, I alluded to this at the very beginning of this video, but automation in no code allows us to move data around and to update things without needing to manually do it. If you have a repeated process in your system, automating it is going to save you big time. The way we do automation inside of SmartSuite is we can build it by clicking up at the top here, and we can come on down to automations. And this is where we can build automations either inside of SmartSuite or interacting with third-party tools. Let's go ahead and create our first automation here, and you see our different triggers that we have. A trigger is the thing that will initiate the automation. So we can say, for example, maybe a record matches very specific conditions. Maybe, for example, we're looking at our pipeline. These were the deals that we had in our third table. And we could say, well, if somebody updates the pipeline stage, for example, to deal one, maybe I want to send an email to my sales team saying, I just closed a deal. I can do that. Right here, I'm saying when the pipeline stage is marked to deal one, then I can build out my actions. So here's where I can say, whatever happens after those conditions are met, I can send a Slack message to the team. I can send a Gmail. I can do something in a Google event. I can send something to Microsoft Teams. I can update records inside of SmartSuite. Automations, they seem deceptively simple, but they can get very complicated, but ultimately are well worth your investment because every automation you build can save you hours in the future. They live forever and continue working in the background while you focus on what matters inside of SmartSuite. Now, I know we went really fast in this video. There is a lot to learn in SmartSuite, so if you haven't already done so, be sure to swing by their website and check them out. And any questions that you have that I didn't address, drop them below this video, and I will work to answer them in the future. That's it for this one, my friend. In the meantime, keep on building.